नमस्कार बच्चों, आप सभी को इस वर्चुअल क्लास में स्वागत है। बच्चों, पिछले एपिसोड में हमने हमारी जो दूसरी यूनिट थी माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स की, इसे नेशनल इनकम और रिलेटेड एग्रीगेट, इस चैप्टर को हमने शुरू किया था। सो इन द लास्ट एपिसोड वी हैव सीन अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ फैक्टर इनकम, द नॉर्मल रेसिडेंट ऑफ अ कंट्री एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डोमेस्टिक टेरिटरी ऑफ अ कंट्री। सो कंटिन्यूइंग दिस चैप्टर अहेड, today we will see how the domestic income can be converted into the national income. So what are the steps are involved in the conversion of national income to the domestic income and the conversion of domestic income into the national income? Before moving to the conversion, we should know that in macroeconomics the concept of income is used as both domestic income and national income, as these both the incomes are same. But thing is what, here when we study about the domestic income and the national income, we have to keep some concepts in mind before getting the meaning of domestic income and the national income. So both the domestic income and the national income includes the factor income received by all the factors of production. So what are the four factors of production? They are land, labor, capital and the entrepreneur. So when these factors, as we have studied that when these four factors of production are combined together, we used to get the goods and services. So when these factors are being hired by the production sector from the household sector, as we know that the household sectors are the owners of all these factors of production. So these factors of production are combined together to produce a goods and services. When they are engaged in the production of goods and services, in return these factors of production are being paid in the form of land will get the rent, labor will get the compensation of employees, capital will be paid as the interest, and the entrepreneurial skills which are being utilized by the producers will be paid in the form of profit. So these factor incomes are included. When we take the total of these incomes, we can say that the combination of all these incomes is the value of domestic income. So let's look at the meaning of domestic income. Domestic income is the sum total of all the factor income generated within the domestic territory of a country during an accounting year, that is the during the period of 1st April to 31st March. And here we should keep in mind that it is the income generated within the domestic territory by both the normal resident and the non-resident. So students, here we need to keep in mind that when we are calculating the value of domestic income, this income will include the income earned by the normal resident and the non-resident. In the previous episode we have very clearly studied about the meaning of normal resident and the non-resident. So the two basic things which I have told in the previous episode, to determine or to identify a person as a normal resident, we have to keep in mind that person should reside in that country for more than 1 year and his economic interest should lie in that country. So at that time we can say that these incomes, the incomes earned by these people, the normal resident and the non-resident, they will be included in the calculation of domestic income. So this is what we have seen about the domestic income, the meaning of domestic income. Look at the national income. So national income is the sum total of factor incomes attributed to the normal resident of a country within the domestic territory of a country or from the rest of the world during an accounting year. So what we can see the difference between the national income and the domestic income, as I told in the domestic income, that it includes the values, it includes the income generated by all the factors of production by the normal resident and the non-resident. But while studying about the national income, it says that it includes only the incomes received by the normal resident, but within the domestic territory of a country and from the rest of the world and from the abroad. So we can say here that the national income will include the incomes which is being generated within the domestic territory and from the rest of the world. That means what? It includes the income earned from domestic territory and the rest of the world. So here when we calculate the value of national income, the national income will include the income earned from abroad. So that income which is being earned from abroad can be calculated as net factor income from abroad. So what do you mean by net factor income from abroad? So net factor income from abroad is the factor income earned by our resident from rest of the world and the factor income earned by the non-resident from our domestic territory. So when we are getting the difference between these two concepts, we get the value of net factor income from abroad. Generally, when we are doing the calculation of national income in our macroeconomics, here the net factor income from abroad, in short abbreviation, we call it as NFIA, the value of NFIA. So students, you keep in mind that when we are in the coming episode, we will be doing the calculation of national income. So at that time, when we are going to do that calculation, so at that time, whenever the abbreviation of NFIA is being given in the questions, you need to understand that it is the value of net factor income from abroad. So how we can get the net factor income from abroad? It is the difference between the factor income earned by our resident from rest of the world and the factor income earned by the non-resident from our domestic territory. So here now we will see how the domestic income can be converted into the national income. Now we will see the conversion of domestic income to the national income. Students, so far we have seen the meaning of domestic income and the national income. Here we will do the conversion. We will learn how the domestic income can be converted into the national income. Accordingly, the domestic income becomes national income provided that in which condition? When we exclude the domestic income, that the part of factor incomes which belongs to the non-resident within our domestic territory, and when we add the domestic incomes, that is the part of factor incomes which our resident earn from the rest of the world. When we take the total of both the factors, the factor incomes earned by our resident and the non-resident, we get the value of NFIA, that is the net factor income from abroad. So here you can see that how the domestic income can be converted to the national income. So when we have the value of domestic income in our hand, so with that value, that is the value of domestic income, when we add the factor income earned by our resident from the rest of the world and we subtract the factor income earned by the non-resident from our domestic territory. So by adding the factor income earned by our resident and by subtracting the factor income earned by the non-resident, we get the value of national income. So in other words, we can say that with the value of domestic income, when we add the value of NFIA, that is the net factor income from abroad, we get the value of national income. So after calculating the conversion of domestic income from the national income, now we will move ahead. We will see the concept of domestic income and domestic product. So what do you mean by domestic income and domestic product? Students, the concept of domestic income and domestic product, both are an identical concept. Both are the same value. So here we need to understand why the domestic income can be said to be the domestic product. बच्चो यहाँ पे हम जो घरेलू आय हैं और घरेलू उत्पाद, इन दोनों के बारे में जानने की कोशिश करेंगे. जैसे मैंने बताया, घरेलू आय और घरेलू उत्पाद ये दोनों एक ही होते हैं. चलिए बताइए कैसे एक होते हैं. जैसे मैंने बताया कि इन दोनों कॉन्सेप्ट्स में किसी तरह की अंतर नहीं है. ये दोनों कॉन्सेप्ट एक है. कैसे एक हैं? क्योंकि ऑल द प्रोडक्शन विच इज बीन डन बाय द फैक्टर्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, दे आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू द फैक्टर इनकम. हाउ दे आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू द फैक्टर इनकम? बिकॉज वी नो दैट एट द फर्स्ट राउंड व्हेन द प्रोड्यूसर्स hires or purchases these factors of production for the production of goods and services, later on in the second round, what we can see that the produced goods and services are sold in the market. When they are sold in the market, the firms get the revenue. When the firms get the revenue through the way of sale of goods and services in the market, so these revenues will be again distributed to the factors of production as their income. That means the production of goods and services which are being produced, that is the product, they are converted into the income of the factors of production. So here we can say that the domestic income is equal to the value of domestic product. That means the values of goods and services, the final value of goods and services which are being produced by the factors of production through the way of production process, they are being sold in the market, and in that way the firms get the revenue, and these revenues will be again distributed to the factors of production in the way of the factor payment, which we call it as the factor income. So by this way we can say that the value of domestic income will be equal to the value of domestic product. बच्चों तो हम ये जान पाते हैं कि यहाँ पे जो घरेलू आय और घरेलू उत्पाद, ये दोनों कॉन्सेप्ट है वो दोनों एक ही है, इनमें किसी तरह की अंतर नहीं है. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर सीइंग द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डोमेस्टिक इनकम एंड द नेशनल इनकम एंड लर्निंग अबाउट द कन्वर्शन ऑफ डोमेस्टिक इनकम टू द नेशनल इनकम, नाउ वी विल सी अबाउट द ग्रॉस and the net concept of domestic product or domestic income. So how we can get the value of gross value and the net value? So domestic product is measured as the gross domestic product or net domestic product. तो बच्चों यहाँ पे हम जो घरेलू वस्तुएं हैं या घरेलू वस्तु हैं, इन्हें हम सकल घरेलू वस्तु या फिर शुद्ध घरेलू वस्तु, जिनको हम शॉर्ट में GDP और NDP कहते हैं. तो बच्चे ये जो मैंने जो बताया GDP और NDP, GDP हियर जी ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट एंड NDP नेट डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट, यहाँ पे जो पहली जो शब्द है ग्रॉस और नेट, ये दोनों जो कॉन्सेप्ट है ग्रॉस और नेट का, इन्हें हम कैसे प्राप्त करेंगे? हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ग्रॉस वैल्यू ऑफ अ डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट एंड द नेट वैल्यू ऑफ अ डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट. सो द ग्रॉस एंड द नेट वैल्यू कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द वैल्यू ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन, जिसे हम मूल्यह्रास कहते हैं. सो व्हाट आई मीन बाय डेप्रिसिएशन? ओके, आई होप यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, इन द फर्स्ट यूनिट, वेयर इट इज द डिक्रीज इन द वैल्यू ऑफ द असेट्स ड्यू टू द नॉर्मल वेयर एंड टियर. तो बच्चों मूल्यह्रास क्या होती है? जब हमारी स्थिर संपत्तियां हैं, इन स्थिर संपत्तियों की जो लगातार या निरंतर उपयोग के कारण उनके मूल्य में जो गिरावट होती है, इन्हें हम मूल्यह्रास कहते हैं. तो बच्चों जैसे ही हम इन मूल्यह्रास की जो मूल्य है, इन्हें हम हमारी डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट या जो घरेलू वस्तुएं हैं इनके मूल्य के साथ घटाएंगे, तब हमें ग्रॉस के जगह नेट वैल्यू मिल जाती है. दैट मीन्स व्हाट स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन वी सब्ट्रैक्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ डेप्रिसिएशन फ्रॉम द वैल्यू ऑफ डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट, we get the value of net value, that is the net domestic product. So the value of NDP will be equal to GDP minus depreciation, or we can say that the value of GDP will be equal to the value of NDP plus depreciation. So always keep in mind that whenever we want to calculate the value of gross and the net value, we need to get the value of depreciation. So depreciation, what we can do here, when the depreciation value is being subtracted from the gross value, we get the net value, and vice versa, that is when the value of depreciation is added with the net value, we get the gross value. So as I told you, net factor income earned from abroad is being, in short we call it as NFIA. At the same time here also, whenever we need to calculate the value of G and N, so what is G? G stands for gross, N stands for net. So when we want to move from gross value to net value, what we need to do? We need to subtract the depreciation. At the same time, when we want to get the net value from the gross value, what we need to do? We need to add the value of depreciation. So by this way, the conversion of gross and the net value will be very easy for us. Likewise, we have two more values, that is GNP and NNP. What is GNP? Gross national product. And NNP is what? Net national product. students, look here carefully. Here we have the value of g and p. That is in between the value of g and p. That is g and p. N stands for national. And again in the NNP, first letter N stands for net, and the second N stands for what? National. So in the both the aggregates of the national income, GNP and NNP, we have the value of N in center. That is the that denotes the value of national. So you should keep in mind that how we can get the value of national product, national income. We have studied earlier that we have to add the value of NFIA, that is net factor income from abroad. So the value which is being given here, that is GNP and NNP, it includes the net factor income from abroad. And what here we need to do? Here we need to convert the GNP value into NNP. So how we can convert the value of GNP into NNP? We can convert the G value into net value by subtracting the depreciation value. And at the same time, when you want to convert the value of NNP into GNP, here the net should be converted into the gross value. So here we will add the depreciation value. Okay, students, here is the second one where we have seen that how the gross value can be converted into the net value. Okay, students, now we will study how the value of domestic product at market price and the factor cost can be calculated. Okay, students, here we need to study what do you mean by market price and the factor cost. So when we study about the two sector economy in a country, where we can see the two sectors, that is the household sector and the producer sector. When we study about the two sector economy, at that time there is no difference between the domestic product at market price and the factor cost. Why? Because we have only two sectors where the household sector used to provide the factors of production, and in return the producer sector pay them back in the form of factor income. So at that time, here we cannot find any kind of difference in the domestic product at market price and the factor cost. But here when we want to study about that kind of economy where along with the household sector and the producer sector, we have one more sector that is being called as what? Government sector. So when the government involves in the economic activity of an economy, there the government used to impose the taxes, that is indirect taxes on the goods and services produced in the economy. So not only in the taxes, even the government used to offer the subsidies to the commodities produced in the economy so that the market value of that commodity can be lowered. So here, due to the involvement of government in the economy in the way of imposing taxes and offering the subsidies, the market price of that commodity will get changed. So the true market value can be estimated by deducting the value of indirect tax and adding up the value of subsidies to the prevailing market prices. So when we add these subsidies to the market prices and subtract the value of indirect taxes from the market value, we get the factor cost. So they are the domestic product at factor cost. So this cost is being derived by subtracting the indirect tax and adding up the subsidies. So by this way, the market price can be converted into the factor cost. So here we can find that when the indirect taxes are calculated to adjust the market prices of the goods and services produced, here we need to find out the value of net indirect tax. What do you mean by net indirect tax? So net indirect tax can be calculated by subtracting the value of subsidy from the indirect tax. So here you got a one more concept. In a short abbreviation, we call it as the NIT, the value of NIT. So that is net indirect tax. So whenever we want to find out the value of domestic product at market price and the factor cost, we need to have the value of NIT in our hand. So when we get the value of NIT, that is the net indirect tax, that is being calculated by subtracting the subsidy from the indirect tax. So by this way, by getting the value of NIT, that is the net indirect tax, we can get the value of market price and the factor cost. So students, look here carefully how we can convert the value, or how we can find out the value of domestic product at market price and the domestic value at factor cost. So here, when we have the value of domestic product at market price, the domestic product can be the net value or gross value, but here we need to calculate the value of domestic product at market price to the factor cost. So how the market price can be converted into the factor cost? As I told you, we have to subtract the value of indirect taxes and add the value of subsidies, because we know that the government will not impose the taxes. Along with the taxes, even the government used to give some subsidies on the goods and services produced in the economy. So by this way, the domestic product at market price can be easily converted to the domestic product at factor cost. How it can be converted? It can be converted by subtracting the value of NIT, that is the net indirect taxes. So how we can get the value of NIT, that is net indirect taxes? By subtracting the value of subsidy from the indirect taxes. After studying about these three concepts, that is NFIA, depreciation and the NIT. So whenever we are going to calculate the aggregates of the national income, that is the value of GDP at market price, NDP at market price, GDP at factor cost, NDP at factor cost, all these aggregates can be calculated, can be converted from one form to another form by having all these three concepts which I have set now, that is the value of NFIA, NIT and depreciation. So by having these three concepts, we can convert any of the related aggregate to one value to the another value. So here now we will focus on the relationship between the related aggregates and how these aggregates can be calculated from one aggregate to the another aggregate. After seeing the concept of NFIA, depreciation and the NIT, that is the net indirect taxes, now we will study about the related aggregates to the national income. We will see some definitions and the interrelationship between the various aggregates of national income. So here these aggregates are divided into eight related aggregates, that is GDP at market price, NDP at market price, GDP at factor cost and the NDP at factor cost. So all these four concepts denotes the value of domestic product of gross and the net value, and the along with the gross and net value we will study about the market price and the factor cost value. So look at the first one, GDP at market price. GDP at market price refers to the market value of final goods and services produced within the domestic territory of a country during the period of an accounting year, inclusive of depreciation or the value of consumption of fixed capital. So the value which we studied about the depreciation value, that can also be said to be the value of consumption of fixed capital. When we study about the GDP value at market price, it includes the value of depreciation. Now come to the NDP at market price. So again, from GDP to NDP, we know that when we are calculating the value of GDP to NDP, that is the net value, we know that the net value can be calculated by subtracting the value of depreciation. तो बच्चों यहाँ पे जैसे ही हम सकल घरेलू जो उत्पाद है मार्केट कीमत के आधार पर, इसके साथ साथ जब हम मूल्यह्रास की जो मान है इसे हम घटा देते हैं, तो हमें बाजार कीमत पर हमें शुद्ध देसी उत्पाद की जो मान है वो मिल जाती है, उसे हम बड़ी आसानी से ज्ञात कर पाएंगे। तो बच्चों यहाँ पे जैसे ही हमारी जो मूल्यह्रास की जो मान है उसे हम घटा देंगे, तो हम मैंने जैसे बताया कि हमारी जो सकल मूल्य और शुद्ध मूल्य, इन सकल मूल्य से शुद्ध मूल्य में जाने के लिए हमें मूल्यह्रास के मान को घटाना होगा, और शुद्ध मूल्य से सकल मूल्य में जाने के लिए हम क्या करेंगे, जो हमारी मूल्यह्रास है इसके मूल्य को सकल मूल्य के साथ जोड़ना होगा। आगे देखेंगे जीडीपी एट फैक्टर कॉस्ट। So GDP at factor cost refers to the sum total of factor income generated within the domestic territory of a country during the period of an accounting year, along with the depreciation value. Okay students, look at this table where the value of GDP at market price, GDP at factor cost, NDP at factor cost and the value of NDP at market price is given. So in the four corners I have given the four values. So here what we need to do, we need to get the values of these concepts which have been given in the four corners. So what we have to learn, so how we can derive the value of GDP at factory cost from GDP at market price, and how we can get the value of NDP at factory cost from GDP at factory cost, and again how we can calculate the value of NDP at market price from NDP at factory cost. So when we need to calculate these values at that term, we have to keep in mind about the values of net indirect taxes and the depreciation. So because here we will not use the value of NFIA, because all these four concepts are related with the domestic product. So with the values of NIT and the depreciation, we can derive any of this value from this table. So students, here see here how the value of GDP at market price is being converted into GDP at factory cost by subtracting the value of NIT, and how we can get the value of GDP at factory cost to GDP at market price by adding the value of NIT. And at the same time, when you want to calculate the value of GDP at market price to the NDP at market price, here the gross value is being converted into the net value. So gross can be converted into net by subtracting the depreciation value. At the same time, when you want to calculate the value of NDP factor cost to GDP factor cost, here the net value of NDP factor cost is being converted into the GDP value, that is the gross value. So how the net value can be converted into the gross value? By adding the depreciation. So at the same time, look at the other two net values given here, that is the conversion of NDP at market price to NDP at factor cost. That is, here the market price is being converted into the factor cost by subtracting the value of NIT, that is the net indirect taxes. And one more thing we can see here, the value of GDP at market price, how the value of GDP at market price is being converted into the value of NDP at factor cost. So when you want to convert the GDP into the NDP, that is G has to be converted into N. So we will subtract the depreciation. Not only we subtract depreciation, here the market price has to be converted into the factor cost. So along with that one, we need to subtract the value of NIT. So by subtracting the value of depreciation and the NIT, we get the value of GDP at market price to NDP at factor cost. After the related aggregates of domestic value, now we will see the related aggregates of national product, that is GNP at market price, NNP at market price, GNP at factor cost, and the NNP at factor cost. Again, all these four concepts of related aggregates are given about the national product value. So here again we know that the value of GNP, that is the gross national product at market price, it is the sum total of the GDP at market price with the net factor income from abroad. See here, as we have learned earlier, that when we are studying about the national concept, the national product value, it includes the value of net factor income from abroad, that is the value of NFIA. So as we have seen earlier a table, at the same way I have given one more, where you can see the four values of GNP at market price, GNP at factor cost, NNP at market price, and NNP at factor cost. They have been given here. So we need to learn how these values can be converted. As I told earlier, when we have converted the related aggregates of domestic income into various related aggregates of national income, so the same way here also we will do the same thing, where with the values of net indirect taxes and the value of depreciation, we can convert these related aggregates to one value to the another value. So students, here generally the value of NNP at factor cost is said to be the national income value. So whenever we are finding out the value of national income in an economy, that income will be, in short, will be explained as the value of NNP at factor cost, that is the value of national income. So students, that's all for today. I hope you understood the concepts clearly. Based on our today's study, I have given some homework. You can note down this homework. You can try it yourself at home, and in case of any doubt, you can contact us. फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. वी विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास विद द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ नेशनल इनकम. सो अंटिल देन, कीप लर्निंग, स्टे सेफ. धन्यवाद.